We have a new style YouTube video for you today. We're going over a different strategy that we haven't covered before, YouTube Shorts. Our TikTok ad content or our Instagram or Facebook ad content, then you're definitely gonna wanna pay attention to this video because we're going over a different strategy that we haven't covered before, YouTube Shorts. And you might notice we're in a different filming location than usual. That's because we're in New York City. We're here because we got invited for an event for collaborations like videos like these where we're able to network with different influencers. So now let's get into the YouTube Shorts strategy video. If you're a creator and you've been posting to TikTok and Instagram and have been seeing any results or incredible results at all, then you might be wondering whether or not YouTube Shorts are definitely worth it. In today's video, we're gonna be covering exactly what strategies you need to use with YouTube Shorts and how you can benefit from them if you're already posting to TikTok and Instagram. So let's go ahead and get into the video. All right, so in today's video, we're covering the YouTube Shorts strategy. And my name is Chase Chappell. We have an agency where we manage 7- and 8-figure brands. And we also have a training where we train thousands of students on exactly how to not only implement ads with TikTok and Facebook, but organic strategies for Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, as well as YouTube included. And here's a little bit about my YouTube experience. All recommendations in today's video are going to be based on data, not personal opinion. And we have posted over 750 plus YouTube videos, and I have over 30,000 YouTube subscribers. So we definitely have some understanding of exactly how the algorithm works, as well as working with clients who have millions of subscribers and knowing what they're applying to their short videos to be able to succeed in their own unique space. And some YouTube short insights. There's 2 billion people who use YouTube every single month. There's a ton of people, and YouTube Shorts receive 15 billion views daily. So you can definitely assure yourselves that your audience is likely on YouTube, and there's definitely market share potentially being able to be captured here with your product, your service, as a creator for an audience, whether you're looking to monetize and earn money here, or if you're a B2B business looking to earn more businesses this way, or even push more product sales, YouTube Shorts can definitely be an avenue for you. And more than 70% of all YouTube watch time is through mobile, and we know that's where the primary Shorts placement is. And more than 70% of YouTube Shorts are longer than 15 seconds. So this is a really good insight to understand, because if 70% of all YouTube Shorts are longer than 15 seconds, then there might be some insights to draw from there on whether or not that's what's working for most creators. And YouTube has 100 million YouTube Shorts creator fund. So if you're a creator and you start making videos, you can definitely earn from YouTube. They do a really good job of not only splitting revenue, but also providing funds for creators to basically earn. So that way you're always being able to not only make a little bit of money from your videos, but also be able to capture sales, whether it's for your products or service. And number 6, YouTube Shorts can be used to gain long form subscribers. Believe it or not, lots of people don't realize how powerful these platforms can be. From our own experience, we've posted TikTok videos where we've literally gotten a video to go viral on TikTok, and it's gotten us thousands of subscribers. Same thing on YouTube Shorts, where you can literally earn hundreds of subscribers, if not thousands, tens of thousands. We had a student go from 5,000 subscribers to over 45,000 subscribers, all from one single YouTube short video that they migrated over from TikTok. And we're gonna be covering this strategy in depth here in a second. And just looking at some of the YouTube short insights, these graphs might look familiar to you. For example, the Shorts algorithm here on the left image, it says 3.6K views. Most people experience a spike in views and then a plateau where their videos usually don't get any more views and they taper off fairly quickly. And this is due to YouTube pushing the video rather quickly, seeing what audiences are engaging. And the moment that the watch times start to take a dive, less people are clicking or less people are beginning to be interested in the video, the more likely it is to have a sudden stop. But if the longer the video is getting pushed out and more people are engaging, the more and more watch time, if those metrics are being maintained, then you're likely to see your video continue to rise. Then we have another example here, and this is the search algorithm. This is a little bit different than getting a spike initially. This is where you post a short, you get some views, but then you have a slow rise over time. And that means that your short is SEO optimized, or it's being suggested underneath another video and is consistently climbing in views. This is really great because it means that it's a video that is maintaining a very specific audience and it's engaging, people are watching it, they're clicking on it, so therefore that video is growing over time. These are great videos because people are searching for them and they're finding value in your short form video. So an idea, for example, would be take a long form video, condense it down into a short form, make sure it has SEO titles in there, and you could potentially be getting views over the long run just by having short based videos. So you might expect views might go up quickly initially and taper off. That is very normal. Number two is you might have views rise more slowly, then go up quickly, and then taper off. And then you might have views that are steadily rising over time because they're being suggested, people are searching for them. And then number four, which is also common, getting no views at all. And this might happen as well if you're a new channel, if your audience hasn't been yet tapped into. It can take many months before you see your first video take off. And we even had, you know, a friend of ours, Alex Stemp, who was posting all of his viral TikTok videos onto YouTube. He posted hundreds of them and they weren't getting very many views at all. But the moment one video took off and went viral, it set off all of his other YouTube short videos. So they had been on his profile for 60 plus days with only a few thousand views. And then one video got over 1 million views and all of his short videos started rising in the hundreds of thousands of views on all of his videos. And his channel blew up and did over 1 million subscribers in just 30 days time. Yes, you heard that right, over 1 million subs. He earned both his 100K plaque button and his 1 million subscriber plaque button in the same month, all because of one viral video activated all of his other ones. So that just goes with saying that his videos weren't necessarily not viral worthy, it's just that the algorithm wasn't favoring them initially. But once one video got the chance to go viral, the algorithm then picked up all the other videos because they were just as good in terms of quality and engagement. They just weren't necessarily being pushed effectively initially with the algorithm. So yes, the algorithm can be squirrely at times. So when we talk about this migration strategy from TikTok to YouTube, what I mean by is if you have a TikTok account and you're posting TikTok videos from that placement primarily, what you can do is download your videos from TikTok without the logo and upload them to YouTube and automatically have videos to migrate to YouTube to start seeing views. You can take all of your videos you have from TikTok and start posting them on the regular as long as they're under a minute in length onto YouTube and start seeing incredible views. So I highly recommend migrating content from TikTok if you haven't already, or vice versa. If you're posting on Instagram Reels or Facebook Reels, whichever vertical placement platform you're leveraging to begin with, you want to migrate that content to your other platform like YouTube. And one thing you'll notice with taking content from your TikTok or your Instagram is TikTok and Instagram really favor, you know, the music that is widely available and trending. And a lot of that music is technically copyrighted in a lot of cases, whereas on YouTube, they, you know, limit videos and also give copyright strikes in a lot of cases with their YouTube shorts. So it's always good to adjust your video music to see if that plays an effect on your virality factor or your view factor in general. And number three, you want to keep your video under 1 minute, because if you don't and it's longer than a minute, then it doesn't necessarily fall under the shorts category. Whereas on TikTok and Instagram, you could likely see that. That video is going to be placed on your main feed channel. So definitely make sure videos are under 1 minute if you want shorts feed delivery. And then when looking at YouTube shorts as a whole, it's always good to create original content for the platform because it's definitely more favorable. Lots of times you're going to want to focus on your title. It's important for SEO. You can make sure to have specific keywords that are similar to very high viewed videos that are long form. Because now on long form videos, you'll notice there's a shorts placement directly under it. And if your video has keywords that are similar to that video, you could show up in the suggested folder there on shorts, and you can see that slow rise with time and get video views that way. And then number two is testing with description as well as without. We've not only seen this with ourselves and other creators, but having no description sometimes results in video views, and having a description also does as well. Lots of times it comes down to the content, but you can test with the description without to see what works best. And number four, you're gonna wanna give the algorithm time. Sometimes it can take a few months before a video even takes off. And you're gonna wanna stay consistent because YouTube definitely favors consistency. We know with longer form videos, if you upload it at a very specific time, week after week or day after day, you're going to see that it favors, and the videos are gonna be more likely to be pushed out because TikTok favors consistency. And that's how they reward you in a lot of cases. So same thing goes for shorts. You're gonna wanna be consistent with your videos. We just recently completed a 30-day challenge with YouTube themselves for a 30-day short series. And during that 30-day period was one of the periods we had our most viewed videos on our channel. We had the most views we've ever had in our entire history of posting on YouTube in that month, all from sticking to a consistent schedule of posting every single day. So this is a challenge you could definitely do. I would highly recommend it. We just completed it with YouTube. If you try it yourself, let me know in the comments how it goes. So those are just a few strategies initially that you can start testing for your YouTube short strategy. I definitely want to show you some examples of students in our program that are absolutely crushing it. For example, this is Scott here, who's a student in our one-on-one ads mastery mentorship, where we show people how to not only get views on TikTok, successfully scale their business, and use ads to scale up their e-commerce, their B2B business, whether they're looking for lead gen or sales in general. And one of the strategies is he started migrating his content from TikTok and went from 5,000 subscribers to 45,000 subscribers, all from a single viral video on YouTube. And for most YouTubers, they understand gaining subscribers is one of the hardest things to do. And it's one of the only platforms that will consistently take a much longer period of time to earn subscribers than any other platform, because subscribers are very authentic. They're very engaged with the channel usually, and it's very hard to earn a subscriber if you're trying to do it very quickly. And he was able to achieve this very fast in just a single month, jumped a ton of subscribers all from a viral video. And that is because it got pushed out on the Shorts algorithm and gained a ton of views, and lots of people ended up interacting with it. And it also helped a lot of his other videos gain views. And this is a great strategy because this exact video was a viral one on TikTok. And if you have a viral video on Instagram or TikTok and it doesn't go viral on YouTube, that doesn't mean it's not necessarily a viral video. It just means that that video might not have been pushed in the way that the algorithm should have effectively pushed it out to the correct audience. So always make sure to have the right titles, test different descriptions, and re-upload the video. See how it does and performs differently. Now, one thing to take note about using strategies like these, you're gonna end up growing in popularity. Your videos are gonna have the chance of going viral, and with getting views and eyeballs means being able to be in front of not only celebrities and other influencers and creators in your space, which opens up the opportunity for you to collaborate. And collaborating is great because you can go to events that you're invited to, just like the one we're invited to today that we're here in New York for. So I'd love for you to join along for the ride so that way you can see exactly what this is like. Go, go, go.
It's your birthday. We gon' party like it's your birthday. We gon' sip a Bacardi like it's your birthday. And you know we don't give a fuck, cause that's your birthday. You can find me in the club, bottle full of bub. Mama, I got what you need. You need to fill the buzz. I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love. So come give me a hug, you're into getting rough. You can find me in the club, bottle full of bub. Mama, I got what you need. You need to fill the buzz. I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love. So come give me a hug, you're into getting rough.
All right, so we just got back from the event. We're in Fort Worth, Texas now. We had an incredible time. I hope you really enjoyed the YouTube short strategy, as well as really enjoy getting to see a little bit behind the scenes about how these influencer events work. And if you haven't already, definitely make sure to like and subscribe to this video because it really does help the algorithm. And if you want to learn more and be able to work one-on-one with myself and team inside of our mentorship, then make sure to DM me the word mentor at Real Chase Chappell on Instagram. In our mentorship, we work one-on-one with you going over TikTok ads, Facebook ads, Instagram organic, and TikTok organic strategies. So that way you can grow your social media page, be able to actually scale up your business while running TikTok and Facebook ads. And we work with 6, 7, and 8-figure businesses inside of this program. Whether you're an e-commerce business, whether you're in the lead generation space, whether you have a local business, then we can definitely work with you directly and be able to help you scale. I hope you really enjoyed this video. It's your favorite digital marketer here, Chase Chappell. Cheers and bye, y'all.